Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'm going to explain you control hazards in pipeline. See, control hazards, that is happening usually because of branch instructions in pipeline structure. Here there are few very essential points that you understand before you solve problems based on control hazards. So I'll explain you each and every point so that you can be able to solve problems based on control hazards very easily. So first of all, you should understand the theory of it. Right, so control hazards, that happens because of branch instructions, remember this. Now let me explain you one practical example in which how exactly control hazards stall the pipeline. For that I'll be considering 4-stage pipeline over here. So see, those stages are like this: instruction fetch, that is my first stage, then second stage is instruction decode, then third stage, that is execute instruction, and fourth stage, that is write back stage. Now to explain you this control hazards, let us consider execution of instruction step by step. So here, first of all, what I'll be doing is I'll be considering addresses, and here I'll be considering instructions. Let us consider one address is there, that is 1000, and first instruction that we are having over here, and all the instruction that is having size of 4 byte. So next instruction address, that will be 1004, then next address, that will be 1008 over here with third instruction, then next instruction that will be having 1012 address, and that is what keeps on repeating for various instruction. And let us say here we are having 2000 address, and at that address let us say IN instruction is there. Right, now what I'll do is I'll explain you pipeline structure over here. So here in pipelining, with respect to time cycles, we'll be executing all these stages. As I have explained you, those stages are happening with respect to cycles. Right, so here what will happen is this first instruction that will be performing instruction fetch during first cycle, during second cycle it will be performing instruction decode, in third cycle it will be performing instruction execution, in fourth cycle it will be performing write back, and in pipeline second cycle will be having fetch instruction 2, right, and then it will be performing instruction decode, execute instruction will happen in fourth, and in fifth it will be performing write back. In third instruction you'll be observing third cycle, that will be having instruction fetch, then instruction decode, then execute instruction, then write back. That is how it will happen. And in fourth instruction, during fourth cycle, there will be instruction fetch, then instruction decode, then instruction execute and write back. That is how cycles will be there, and this will happen with normal execution. Right, here there is no hazard right now, but hazard will happen during branch instruction. So let me explain you how. So for that, let us consider this I1 instruction that is having branch instruction, and let us say this branch that is happening at 2000 location. Right, so what will happen? So when you see these stages, so during execute stage, in branch instruction it will be identifying what should be the location. So after first instruction, what will happen? Technically, after first instruction, it should jump at address 2000 location and it should execute IN instruction. But if you observe, when it execute this, at that time, already in pipeline, these instructions are having this many operations. And that is what we need to remove from the pipeline, as in branch instruction, after first instruction, which should be my next instruction? INth instruction, right? So we need to flush the pipeline over here. Means this many stage that we need to remove. So here, my dear students, because of branch, during execute, remember this, during execute stage, instruction will be having idea about what should be the location at which we need to jump, right? So as it identifies, during execute stage, see, during this stage, it will identify. So as it will identify that, what will happen? Whatever pipeline that we have filled, that we need to flush over here, right? That's why we need to remove this, and you'll be observing in next cycle, after this third cycle, what we need to do? We need to have this INth instruction during fourth, right? So instruction fetch, that will happen from here, right? So here you see this many cycles that we need to flush over here, right? And then from fourth onwards, instruction fetch, instruction decode, that will be happening because of branch. Now there is some basics that you need to note down over here. The reason is, this is what students are missing. Like, they are thinking, like, when there will be branch, at that time there will be flushing of pipelining with respect to number of stages. No, my dear students, it is not happening with respect to number of stages. Remember this, it is happening with respect to execute stage. Again and again I'm repeating this, it will happen with respect to execute stage. So you see, that will happen with respect to execute stage, and execute stage, that is happening at third stage. That's why in this video specifically I have noted, like, execute stage, that is third stage over here, right? So stall of pipeline, that will happen with respect to execute stage. And you see how many stalls are happening, two cycle stalls are happening over here. So third stage, that is there with execute, and that execute stage minus one, that will be number of stall because of branch instruction. Let me mention that over here. So during branch, number of cycle stall, that is equals to execute stage minus one. Over here, execute stage, that is happening at third stage. So 3 minus 1 means 2. That is how you'll have to remember how many cycles that is getting stalled because of branch instruction. That is case number 1. Now, there can be question like, how we can resolve this issue, right? So my dear students, you can resolve this issue by having branch prediction. So already with Pentium architecture in 2000, when Intel's have introduced with Pentium structure, at that time they have added branch prediction logic. And branch prediction logic that they have implemented with the accuracy of 95%. I have already made video based on branch prediction logic of Pentium architecture of Intel, right? But here it will be quite complicated as if I explain it over here. So for that, you just go through my video based on that branch prediction, in which I have explained how we can resolve the issue of that control hazard that is happening because of branch, right? Still, if anything that you would like to share it with me, please note it down in comment box. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.